Hello students, today's topic is phases of compiler. It is the part of the subject compiler and also in the principles of programming languages. Let's start the topic phases of compiler. Compilation process follow the sequence of various phases. They are lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, semantic analyzer, intermediate code generator, code optimizer, and the last code generator. So here you can see that there are six phases of compiler. Each phase takes the input from its previous phase and produce the output. This output is treated as the input of the next phase. Symbol table and error handler are the two more modules that interact with all the phases of the compiler. And symbol table is to use to store the data, and error handler is for handle the errors. Now let's explain each and every phase with the help of the example. Lexical analyzer takes input as the source code. Here in our example, our code is A equals to B plus C multiplied by 60. Let us assume that A, B and C are the real values, whereas 60 is the integer value. So in lexical analyzer, as we know, it is the initial phase of the compiler. It scans the input. It is also called the scanner. It helps to generate the token. Here A is the identifier 1, B is the identifier 2, C is the identifier 3. Now these token is go through towards the syntax analyzer. These are the tokens which goes to the syntax analyzer as the input. Now syntax analyzer takes input from lexical analyzer, checks the correctness of the program code and produce the syntax tree. It is also called the parser. Here we make a syntax tree equals identifier 1 plus identifier 2 multiplied by identifier 3 into the 60. The next phase is semantic analyzer. In this phase, the main function is the conversion, the type conversion. It also recognizes the syntactic structure produced by the syntactic analyzer. Here identifier 1, identifier, identifier 2, identifier 3, these are the identifier of A, B and C, and A, B, C are the real values. So here we need to convert the 60 into the integer to real. Hence semantic analyzer converts 60 into the real. The next phase is intermediate code generator. It generates the three address code with the help of the temporary variable. Here T1, T2 and T3 are the temporary variables. First of all, we store 60 in the T1, that is temporary variable 1. Now we store 60.0 because it converts into the real. T1 equals 60.0, T2 equals identifier 3 multiplied by identifier 1. Means identifier 3 multiplied by T1, that is 60. Next, T3 equals identifier 2 plus T2. Identifier 2 plus T2 means identifier 3 multiplied by 60. And at the last, T3 stores in identifier 1. The next phase is code optimizer. This is the optional phase. It optimizes the code which is produced in the code generator. If you need to optimize the code, then we use this phase. Now here T1 equals to identifier 3 multiplied by 60. These two lines are optimized into the one line. Now identifier 1 equals to identifier 2 plus T1, and means temporary variable 1. Our last phase is code generator. Code generator generates the code to the target language. Here we write assembly codes, move, first of all identifier 3, then move identifier 3 into the R2, multiplied by 60 into R2, multiply 16 into R2, then move identifier 2 into R1, add these R1 and R2, and at the last move R1 into the identifier 1. In this symbol table, A, B and C are stored, and error handler handle all the errors which is produced in these phases. Thank you. Thanks for watching.